Okay, so welcome back po sa ating YouTube channel. So sa video presentation na to guys, ang isi-share ko sa inyo ay kung paano po tayo mag-prepare para sa ating examination sa renewal sa ating mga IQAMA. Okay? Kasi napaka-importante po yan ngayon guys. Kasi hindi po tayo makapag-renew ng ating mga IQAMA kung hindi po tayo makapag-exam ng Saudi Professional Verification Program. Okay? So bagong patakaran po ng Saudi Arabia sa lahat ng mga trabahante na nandito sa kanilang kaharian. Okay? So panoorin nyo po yung video na to.
8 conditions for Saudi Professional Verification Program. The Saudi Human Resources Social Development Ministry has launched the fourth phase of the Professional Verification Program, under which doctors, engineers, accountants, technicians, and the paramedical staff will have to pass a test for the IQAMA renewal. 5 stages professional verification implementation. First phase on July 1, 2021, companies with 3,000 or more workers. The second phase on September 1, 2021 with 500 to 2,999 workers. The third phase on October 1, 2021 with 50 to 499 workers. The fourth phase on November 3, 2021 with establishment 6 to 49 workers. The fifth phase will be next year, January 2, 2022, establishment with less than 6 workers. Theoretical exam for IQAMA renewal for electrician category. 15 questions that need to be answered within 30 minutes. Examiner, choose your preferred language. Available languages are Arabic, English, Urdu, Filipino. The exam is divided into two sections. First, computer-based theoretical test. Second, practical test. Take note, all these questions are examples only for your preparation. Question number 1. What device is used for continuity test? A. Multimeter. B. Micrometer. C. Caliper meter. So the answer is multimeter. Question number 2. What happened when phase wire touching in the neutral wire? A. Nothing happened. B. Voltage increase. C. Short. D. Voltage drop. So the answer is short. Question number 3. Which instrument is used for insulation test? A. Meager or insulation tester. B. Clamp meter. C. Precision screwdriver. D. All of the above. So the answer is Meager or insulation tester. Question number 4. Which instrument is not used for electrician? A. Diagonal pliers. B. Phillips screwdriver. C. Gloves. D. Manifold gauge. So the answer is manifold gauge. Question number 5. Identify the symbol in the picture. A. Grounding. B. Neutral. C. Bus bar. D. All of the above. So the answer is grounding. Question number 6. Before pouring cement in the flooring, what should be the electrician needs to do? A. Cover all conduits, utility box, junction box in the flooring. B. Wait for the instruction of the management. C. Talking with co-workers. D. All of the above. So the answer is cover all conduits, utility box, junction box in the flooring. Question number 7. Which type of circuit breaker called miniature circuit breaker below? E, B, C, D. So the answer is D. Question number 8. In distribution panel switchboard, how many terminal lines are enclosed? A, 4. B, 3. C, 5. D, 2. So the answer is C, 5. Question number 9. Which bend of the conduit is called 90 degree? E, B, C, D. So the answer is C. Question number 10. What is normal house wiring voltage? A, 380 volts. B, 440 volts. C, 230 volts. D, all of the above. So the answer is C, 230 volts. After you finish, click next. Then you will see thank you. Prepare your practical test. In practical test, these are the diagrams that you need to practice before going to exam. How to wire two switches controlling one bulb plus convenience outlet. How to wire two switches and intermediate switches, one bulb controlled in two locations. How to wire two switches, one bulb controlled in two locations.
Pagkatapos nating mag-exam, after 30 minutes guys, ay pwede na nating malaman kung pumasa po ba tayo sa ating ginawang examination. So, panoorin niyo po ang video na to.
Okay guys, so pagkatapos natin sa ating examination, ang susunod nating gawin guys ay i-check natin kung pumasa po ba tayo sa ating ginawang examination. So ngayon guys, ang susunod nating gawin guys ay pumunta tayo dito sa official website ng KIWA. Okay? So, pag nandun na po tayo sa kanilang portal, ang susunod natin gawin guys ay so, i-click lang natin yung eligibility of worker, no? Yan. At i-select mo yung IQAMA number. Pagkatapos guys, i-input mo lang yung IQAMA number mo. Dito natin malalaman guys kung pumasa po tayo sa examination. Okay? So, may nakalagay dito or may nakasulat dito, owner of IQAMA number. Ito po yung IQAMA number. At ito po yung remarks, no? The labor pass the exam in occupation. Okay? So, yan po yung basihan kung pumasa po kayo dun sa examination. Ito po ay nagiging kulay green, no? So kung hindi po kayo pumasa guys, ang makasulat dito, the labor did not pass the exam in occupation. Tapos read ang nakasulat dito. Okay?